Moving ahead in the discussion that we had in the last session, that was on the prefixes and how they help us in finding out the meaning of unfamiliar words. We move on to how suffixes and roots will help us and to know more about suffixes and roots. So the first thing that we do is we come to suffixes. Now suffixes are affix that are attached to the end of a root word to modify its meaning or to create new words. Now they can be of three kinds. It can be noun suffix, it can be a verb suffix, or it can be an adjective suffix. Let's look at all the three kinds with examples. For the noun suffix, the common ones are when it ends in ment, meant. Now the meaning of ment, the suffix, is condition of. So the words that we get are, they are speaking about the condition of being in that state of that place. So argument, placement. The second noun suffix that we have picked up is dom, D-O-M. And the meaning is state or place of being. So when you are having any state or place where you find yourself in, then you use the suffix D-E-D-O-M. The words that we have picked is freedom, boredom. The third one is S-H-I-P, ship. And that means the position held. Now ship and position held means that all the nouns that are depicted by such words will tell you that the word that comes before it, the root word, means that the position is being held there. So ownership and internship. Internship is the position that an interns hold, and ownership is a position that the owner holds. Now we come to the verb suffixes. Now in the verb suffixes, the first example that I have is A-T-E-E-N-I-Z-A. Look at the words. The meaning is become. Look at the words for A-T-E. Regulate, fortunate, etc. So, anybody who is becoming or having fortune is fortunate and enjoying their state. E-N. E-N gives you awaken, weaken. So if you are, if you have become weak, then you call it a weakened position. Then I have I-Z-E, gives you socialize, idolize. So when you start or think to become a social person, you socialize. These are the verb suffixes. And the last, the second one is I-F-Y or F-Y, and the meaning is make or become. Almost similar to this. All of them are verb suffixes. The words satisfy, stupefy, rectify, terrify. Moving on, after the verb suffix, we move to the adjective suffixes. Now, adjective suffixes, the first one is able, ible, capable of being. So, if you are having this suffix, then you are capable of possessing this quality. So if it is, the words that are given is profitable, comfortable. Let's look at the second adjective suffix, ish, meaning having the quality of. So suppose if you have the qualities of a child, then it is childish, an adjective for that. And if you are a snob, then it is a snobbish. So the third one is L-E-S-S, the meaning is without. So this will take away that quality. Endless, lawless, etc. So these are the different suffixes and the form in which they come to you in grammar. In the grammatical performance and function, they could be verbs, they could be adjectives, they could be nouns. Now we move to some common roots. And in the common root section, the first one is enim, which means mind, body, life, or spirit. Look at the words. Equanimity, equanimity, enmity, unanimous. Unanimous means of equal minds. Equanimity means of equal minds. Unanimous is without dispute of the same, dispute of the same mind. Magnanimous, made up of two words. Magnus, the first part, means great. And animus in the second part makes it of great minds. Similarly, pusillanimous. Now, pusillus is another root word which means very small. So when it combines with enim, it becomes people with very small minds. The second root is fit. Fit means faith. Now with fit, the words concerning faith are confide, fidelity, bona fide of good faith, fiduciary is a trustee. So all these words contain the meaning faith. Third one is trans. Now trans is a root word which means across, beyond or through. The words transfer, transport, translate. Now trans is across and port means carry. So transport is something which is carrying things from one place to another. It is taking things across. The fourth group that we are discussing is C-E-D-E, seed. Now that means to grow or to yield. The words conceed, exceed, proceed, precede, antecedent. Antecedent are things that have come in the past, that have happened before. So all these words have the meaning to go or yield. When you concede something, you let go of certain things, you surrender. The last root word that we have picked up for this session is chron, which means time. Now time gives you, chron gives you words like anachronism, that means out of place, out of, in the wrong time. Chronic, continuing for a very long time. Chronological, a logical sequence of events that happens with time. And synchronize is you set two clocks at the same time together. So two events happening at the same time. Now after this session, I hope your vocabulary understanding and memorizing or remembering or retaining the words that you have learned for vocabulary becomes much easier and clearer. I hope this helps you in learning and understanding the words that is required for your preparation and CAT examination. Thank you.